Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. So my dear students, you are welcome to another edition of our online mathematics class. So we still continue on quadratic equation. And you remember I gave you one example last time. So this is example two now. That's the question on the board. The question is, if n and n are the root of quadratic equation 2y squared minus 3y minus 7 equals 0. You should find what? Find sum of roots and product of roots. Then also, you find n squared plus n squared. Now, how do we do this? You know, I told you earlier that it's not necessary the variable be x. You see this one, I use variable m and n, and for the equation I use variable y. The first one, which means we say that you should find the sum and product of root. You know our equation is 2y squared minus 3y minus 7 equals 0. When you compare that equation to general equation of that equation, which is ax squared plus bx plus c equals to 0, but in this case, you know it will be what? Ay squared plus by plus c equals to 0. So if you see that our a is what? Our a is 2, our b equals minus 3, and our c equals minus 7. Now for the first question that says you should find the sum of roots. Sum and product of roots, are they? So for sum of roots, our sum of roots, this is m and n, is equivalent to what? M plus n. So it means that our m plus n is now equal to what? From the formula I've given you already, minus b over a. So which means our m plus n is minus into brackets minus 3, amen, over what? What's our e? 2. So which is what? We have 3 over 2. Then for the product, that is n, and that mn is equal to what? Our c over a. What is our c? Our c is minus 7, our a is 2. So we have minus 7 over 2. Then the third question, the second one, which is b, says you should find n squared plus n squared. I think this one, from the first example I did, when you derive this, you derive this from what? From, you derive this from m plus n everything squared, I mean, which we know to be what? N squared plus n squared. The space is not enough, I'm coming. So, which is from m plus n everything squared equals n squared plus n squared, I mean, then plus what? 2nn. Since, let me clean this side so that you can see this clearly. Now, I said from m plus n everything squared, which we know to be what? N squared plus n squared, right? Plus 2nn. You know this is what we need. You can read this one with this side. Then from here you have m plus n squared minus 2nn. So which means this thing is equivalent to what? To this. So therefore, our m plus n squared, therefore our m squared plus n squared is equivalent to this minus 2nn. And we know this already. Our m plus n is what? That is 3 over 2. So just put it there that
You now have m squared plus n squared equals 3 over 2, everything squared, minus 2 to bracket. What's our mf?
When you come here, our mn is minus 7 over 2.
So, minus 7 over 2. So, from here, we have, this one will be 9 over 4. Then, minus times minus, that's plus. Then, it now becomes plus 2 times 7, 14. Have it? We have 14 over what? Over 2. And 14 over 2 is what? That is 7. So, from here, what do you get? Now, so which means that we have 9 over 4 plus 7. So which is 9 over 4 plus, which is 9 plus 7 times 4 is 28 over what? Over 4. So what do you get? So which means we have 27, we have 27 over 4. Then, after that, the next one, C, says we should find n minus n everything raised by 2. I think that's question C. This one also, when you look at this one, you will see that its expansion is this, m minus n into bracket n minus n, which is m squared plus n squared minus 2mn. That's what you get when you do your expansion, right? So from here, and we know our m squared plus n squared to be what? To be 37 over what? Over 4. So from here, we now have, you substitute the fact we have here, which is 37 over 4 minus 2 into brackets. What's the value of mn? You have already known that to be what? To be minus 7 over 2. So you now put it here, minus 7 over 2. And from here, what do you get? You now be 37 over 4. So from here, our m minus n squared will now be 37 over 4 plus this one. We cancel this. If you know it everywhere, then what next? 7 plus 7. So which means this one is 1. So the SM is what? 4. We have 37 plus 4 times 7 is 28, right? So plus 28. I think you know that one. So from here, what you get? So we now have 37 plus 28. What's 37 plus 28? That is this one we have, that's 65 at best. So we have this one 15, right? So that is 65 over 4 for that one. Now, the next one is D, says we should find m raised to power 3 plus n raised to power 3. This one, you remember, when you are given something like this, when you are given this, we derive this from what? From n plus n squared. Everything squared. Also, when you are given n raised to power 3 plus n raised to power 3, you can also derive this from n plus n everything is power 3.
Are you getting it now? So you derive this thing from that.
When you do that, you will get what are you going to get? So you see that this thing is equivalent to n plus n plus of the space. Let me minimize this space. So it will be m is to power 3 plus n is to power 3. It will be equal to
it will now be
n plus n everything raised to the power 3.
Are you getting it now?
Power 3. So that will be minus 3 n squared plus 3 n squared n.
How do I get this? It's very simple. From this, from your Pascal triangle, those that are doing fundamentals, you know that one.
You can, how did I get this? Let's say I have m plus n now, this power 3.
There is something we call Pascal triangle. Let me quickly sketch it here.
Let me quickly sketch that Pascal triangle here. So,
you see, that Pascal triangle is like this.
1, 1, 1.
So 1, 2, 1, 1, 3, 2 plus 1, 3, 3, 1. It starts with 1 and it ends with what? 1. So this is for any number is for 0, this is raised to power 1, this is for 2, this is for 3. So this is for any number is for 0, this is for 1, this is for 2, this is for 3. What's the purpose of this Pascal triangle? We use it to expand an expansion that the power is more than 2, so that it will be very easier for us. Now look at this one now. It is raised to power 3. So how do we now make use of this Pascal triangle? There is still another one that is binomial expansion, but this one is very simple. Now you know the variables are m and n. We just say m plus n raised to power 3. You just write m n. How many digits we have here? 1, 2, 3, 4. So it means it will be plus n plus m n in 4 times plus m n. When you count, you use that 1, 2, 3, 4 in 4 times. So you start this one from 3. Are you getting now? You see 7, 1, 2, 3. 3, 2, 1, 0. So it means if this one is 3, we have 2, we have 1, we have 0. So this one is 0, 1, 2, 3. At the end of the day, you will have something like n raised to power 3. This one is 1 now. Now n raised to power 0. Then plus, here we have n squared n. Then plus n squared plus n raised to power 3, because this one will also be 1. Now how do I get my this thing now? We now have this digit. We just, the first digit is what? 1. You put 1 here, 3, you put 3 here, this is 3 also, you put 3 here, then here you put 1, so that at the end of the day you have, at the end of the day you have m raised to power 3 plus 3m squared n plus 3m n squared plus n raised to power 3. So when you rearrange it, you will have m raised to power 3 plus n raised to power 3, then plus 3m squared n plus 3m n squared. You know, this is what I'm looking for, Abby. This is what I need. You see, so it means that this here 3m is common. It's not m raised to power 3 plus n raised to power 3 plus 3m. You now plus, you open this bracket,
We have M plus N.
Are you getting it now? M plus N. So this one will give you,
you have 3mn outside, sorry, 3mn, so that you have m plus n.
When you expand this bracket, this one will give you 3m square n plus 3mn square, which is what we have here. But this is what I need, and this one is equal to this. So it means you can now say that m, so which means you can now say that n plus n raised to the power 3 equals n raised to the power 3 plus n raised to the power 3 plus 3m n into bracket m plus n. Are you getting this now? So when you do that, what will happen? This is what I need to bring this one here. You now m plus n raised to the power 3 minus 3m n, this then equals m raised to power 3 plus n raised to power 3, because this one plus this plus, when it comes to this place, it becomes what? Minus. Now this thing I have now, this thing I have now, we now represent the value I'm going to find. Are you getting it now? So which means that this value here now, you see this value now, you know this is minus. Are you getting it now? So we can now say that therefore, you see that therefore, we see our n is power 3 plus n is power 3 equals m plus n, m is power 3 minus 3 m n into bracket m plus n. Are you getting that? Which is what I have here. So therefore this thing now, we now have m is power 3 plus n is power 3 equals m plus n, m is power 3 minus 3ms into brackets. Are you seeing it?
M plus n. Right, m plus n.
Now, you now have M, you now have M, this part 3 plus N, this part 3 equals M plus N, this part 3 minus 3MN into brackets M plus N. So, what's next? We know our m plus n, so it now means that our m is power 3 plus n is power 3 will now be equals, what is our m plus n? So